Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss English literature. Those students who are opting out English literature in 11th class, the video is for them. You know that English literature is somewhat different from colloquial language or general language or general English. Literature is something to which we can say that it is related with our life. If I say that literature is the name of life, there is no exaggeration, because whatever we perceive in our daily day-to-day life, we sometimes we write it, sometimes we experience it, and sometimes we share it with others. So generally English literature begins with our experiences. If I say that from which genre, from which category English has been studied, and English is reputed, English is an established language, English literature throughout the beginning, throughout its journey, was from Old English, which started in 1450 to 1066, and then after, periods of English literature continued. The language and literature are sometimes very complemented to each other, and sometimes these both terms are quite different. So if you can speak English, it doesn't mean that you can understand literature at the same time. And if you can understand literature, it means that you have implied mind, you have the power to grasp the plethora, grasp the enjoyment of literature. So English literature for me is not different from life. It is the second life, I can say. So I am going to start with some simple terms like sonnet, novel, drama, poetry, non-fiction, If I say what novel is, you have heard the name, you have heard the word novel, it means that a long story in which the writer uses imaginary conditions, imaginary experiences, imaginary story he creates, he needs. And sometimes a writer, whatever he perceives, whatever he experiences, he writes it down. So that is novel. And in other words, I can say that novel is a long story, the story in bulk, the story in various forms. And novel has so many types, like science fiction, like horror novel, which is called gothic novels, like epistolary novels, and so on. And drama generally in Greek literature and in Latin literature and in English literature also, in beginning drama was very famous art of literary figures. Drama, in starting drama has 5 parts, but gradually some writers, some playwrights shortened its form and they made the drama in just one act. So generally drama has 5 acts, but playwrights like Henrik Ibsen and George Bernard Shaw, they made drama shortened and they made the form, the drama, in 1 or 2 or 3 acts. So generally, if we say that how many parts are there, how many acts are there in a drama, you can say generally 5 acts, but gradually the writers, the playwrights made it in 3, 4 or 2 forms. And secondly, how many parts are there of drama? Drama may be tragedy, drama may be comedy, drama may be tragic comedy, it may be romantic drama and so on. And third, poetry. Poetry has also so many parts like sonnet, epic, Shakespearean sonnet, Italian sonnet, and ballad, elegy, and so on. And last, non-fiction. Non-fiction means a writer who writes his ideas, his experiences in a form, whatever he perceives in actual life, that is written, and that is called non-fiction. Sometimes we can say that a diary is the form of non-fiction. It is not fictional, but it is experience, so that we can say non-fiction to diary, non-fiction to essays. Essays are also part of non-fiction. So these are general terms of literary students. These are general terms for literature, and those who are reading English literature, it is quite important for them to read such types. And now I am going to tell you what you should read in literature and what you shouldn't, and how literature is different from colloquial language. So English literature, when you read a novel or drama, you must be aware that what kind of term, what kind of prologue is used in the story or in the fiction or so on. Like if there is somewhat very torturing experience is written by the writer, and the writer is favoring to a woman, that is called feminism. If a writer is using so many complicated situation between imperialistic thoughts, between master and servant, that is Marxism theories. And if writer is using so many psychological theories, that is called psychoanalytic theories. And psychological novels are sometimes very important, like Virginia Woolf's A Man's Room, and Sons and Lovers, and so on. So in brief, I am going to tell you, and I have told you, that these are general forms, and you must be aware that novel, drama, poetry and non-fiction are literary parts. And there is a huge difference between drama, a drama and a novel. You cannot say that drama and novel are very complementary, very closely associated with each other, not. But drama has its own theme, novel has its own, and generally most of movies are based on novels, but earlier there was not the developing form of drama. Therefore writers like Shakespeare, Christopher Marlowe and all university wits, along with Ben Jonson and Robert Greene, Kidd and Thomas Laws, and so many writers, they developed the form of drama. And especially drama was flourished in the age of Elizabethan, which was under the period Renaissance. And in 1503 to 1660 or so on, in 1647, drama was quite famous. And the playwrights, most of William Shakespeare, Ben Jonson, Christopher Marlowe, Thomas Laws, Thomas Kidd, Robert Greene, and Robert Burton, John Webster, and so many playwrights were very famous at the time. They wrote both tragedies and comedies, and they gave something unique contribution to English literature. So drama flourished at that time, but novel, if I say, novel was quite popular in the time of Restoration, in the time of neoclassical period, and in the time of Romantic age, where some famous novelists like Samuel Richardson, Jane Austen, Laurence Sterne, and Sir Walter Scott, Charles Dickens, Thomas Hardy, and so many. They were quite famous novelists. Charles Dickens, Jane Austen were the famous writer of romanticism, and the form of novel earlier flourished by some famous writers like Jonathan Swift and Daniel Defoe and Ephra Behn. They made novels, and the written work, the written stuff of them is not called quite popular, not called the form, adjective form of novel. We cannot say that the work written by some famous writers like Jonathan Swift, Daniel Defoe and Ephra Behn is called a novel, because the adject form, adject theme was flourished, was written by Samuel Richardson. Therefore, the starting of novel started in the era of Richardson. And now, if I discuss what poetry is, poetry has so many parts, poetry has so many forms. Beowulf and Widsith. Beowulf is the famous English work which was written earlier in Old English, and throughout the year, throughout the beginning, and from beginning to end, we have been reading so many poems. But the general form of poetry started in Old English, where so many unusual and so many archaic words were used by the writer, were used by the poet. And next, there when a number of writers gathered and a number of writers and number of poets, they assimilated so many things. They assimilated the correct form of poetry, they assimilated the correct form of surnames. They all were very educated, they all were very well flourished, they all were very unique and well established, and they knew that something should be given to English literature. Therefore, they made the particular form of poetry. And in the age of Chaucer, Rima Royal, Ottawa Rima, and the form of various poetries flourished. And in the age of Shakespeare, or in the age of Elizabethan, we see that a number of writers at the time flourished, and they made the unique form of poetry. And the 14 line poem is called sonnet. Seven line Rima Royal, 8 line and a long poem where heroic deeds are presented by the poet is called an epic. In over literature, in over history, we see Ramayana and Mahabharata. These are two greatest epic in Indian mythology. At the same time, a number of epics were written in Greek and Latin as well, and they were translated in different languages. Greek and Latin language are closely associated with English. Therefore, almost all the famous works were translated into English, like Iliad and Odyssey, and Ovid's work, and the work of Aristotle, Plato's work, and so many a number of writers. They translated their work in different languages. When the writers came to know that earlier Greek and Latin languages established, therefore they translated their languages into their own. So epic is a poem, or epic is a particular written work that is generally very long, and from beginning to end a work of a hero is shown in that. How a hero faces, how a protagonist faces different situations in different areas, in different modes, that is shown in epic. And simply we can say that to exaggerate a condition, to exaggerate a hero, and to make himself, to make him very great, epic is written. And how does a hero confront so many obstacles, hindrances, that, and how does he kill the Kedemon to the demon, that is shown in epic. And we are quite aware with our greatest epics, and that those are Ramayana and Mahabharata, where we see how does Lord Ram kill the demon, kill the king, the greatest mammoth and very dangerous king Ravan. So throughout, through beginning to end, we see that how Ravan was killed. Similarly, in epic, we see that how a hero, how a protagonist faces so many different situations, and how does he get triumph, how does he get victory, that is shown in epic. And the kudos, obviously kudos is also shown in that. And second thing is, epic has an another form that is called mock epic. When all the imaginary as well as heroic deeds and some supernatural parts are shown, but along with it the poet tries to condemn, tries to satirize the condition of the hero and condition of the protagonist. In simply I can say that in mock epic the poet abhors, the poet satirizes to the protagonist, and that is called mock epic. So in four form, first that is novel is a long story in which a novelist tries to write all his experiences or all his imaginary parts, whichsoever comes into his mind, he tries to write that. Secondly, that is drama. Actually, I had to return this first form upper, but now I'm going to tell you what drama is. Drama is generally in five acts, that is played on a stage, that is played on in theater. And in the drama, after one to another act, when one act finishes, the curtain downs and first act complete. So drama has 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1 part. The next is poetry, and drama may be tragedy, comedy, and romantic comedy, and tragic comedy, and so on. Next, poetry. Poetry also has so many forms like sonnet, rhyme or royal, ottava rhyma, epic, mock epic, ballad, elegy. Elegy is the song, is the poem which is written over the death, over the demise of beloved ones of the poet. And elegy, in generally, elegy is written in the form of lament, in the emotional form of lament. And next is non-fiction, where the writer tries to express his own experiences in the form of essays, that is called non-fiction. These are general forms. And if we discuss a number of other things, we see that who was the greatest essayist in English? Francis Bacon was the greatest, and he is called the father of English essay. And novel was flourished, novel was developed by the famous writer Samuel Richardson. Poetry, if I say that when poetry flourished, the age of poetry was Old English, and that was 450 to 1066. Where we see the greatest English poem, Beowulf. And non-fiction, a number of writers, they wrote a number of things, the number of stuff, and which we see that how does a writer tries to write his own experiences. These were general parts. I will discuss further. Thank you. Okay, sir.